Good morning, all of you. I welcome you all on behalf of Brihanmumbai Municipal Corporation Education Department to present an online lecture of Standard 6th Medium English and Subject Mathematics. The topic that we are going to see today is three-dimensional shapes. And myself, your today's expert teacher, Neha Dhanke. So today's lesson is for standard 6 subject mathematics and the topic three-dimensional shapes. The units that we are going to see in this lesson is sphere, cone, cuboid, pyramid, prism and cylinder. The objective of this lesson will be the student will be able to identify the number of faces, vertices and edges of a rectangular prism, cube, triangular prism, cylinder, pyramid, cone and sphere. So this is the objective of our today's lesson.
Shapes, cube, cuboid, okay. Prism and pyramid.
Just hold on. Okay, so before starting this lesson, I will tell you, we will start the lesson. The introduction of the lesson will be done with a small video. Just observe the video. From this video, we will be able to learn what is exactly three-dimensional shapes, why we call an object a three-dimensional shape. So just observe the video, listen to the video very carefully. So it will be easy for you to understand the concept of further shapes. So just I will start the video. Just listen and watch the video very carefully. What all objects are shown in this video, how, why it is called three-dimensional, why it is called two-dimensional. Observe it very carefully. Okay, students, let's start.
Shapes, cube, cuboid, prism and pyramid. In our daily lives, we see different things, such as books, football, tables, dice, ice cream cones, etc. All these shapes are solid. These shapes are not flat, like rectangles, circles, etc. We call them three-dimensional shapes. Let's understand them. There are three figures here. The first figure is a line segment whose length is 5 cm. Here we have described this line segment only on the basis of length, that is, only on one measurement. In this way, if we can describe a figure on the basis of just one measurement, then we call it as one-dimensional figure. The ray, the line, is also a one-dimensional figure. Talking about the second shape, it is a rectangle whose length is 5 cm and width is 3 cm. Can this rectangle be described here based on just length or just width? Think, think. No, here it is necessary to tell us both measurements. To describe a figure where we have to tell two measurements, then it is called a two-dimensional figure. In short, we write 2D for two-dimensional. Generally, all flat shapes like squares, pentagon, circles, etc. are two-dimensional, that is, 2D shapes. So can you now tell how many measurements are necessary to describe the third shape? Think, think. Absolutely right. This shape is a cuboid. To describe it, we need to tell the measure of its length, height, as well as width. A figure in which we need three measurements to describe is called a three-dimensional figure. In short, we write 3D for three-dimensional. Generally, all solid shapes such as cube, cuboid, prism, etc. are three-dimensional or 3D shapes. Let us know about three-dimensional or 3D shapes.
Thank you, students, for watching the video. So from this video, we have learned that what is exactly three-dimensional shapes. So the shapes which have only one measurement, we call it as one-dimensional shape. The shapes which have only two measurements, that is length and width, it doesn't have an height, okay? Or in case of width, we can call it as height, but it has only two measurements. Like it is on the flat surface, we need to draw the objects on the flat surface. That objects are called as two dimensionals. But the objects which we can hold with our hand, okay? The objects which we can hold which we can pick up, we will call that objects as 3D objects. So there is a difference between 2D and 3D. So just make a clear concept what exactly is 3D. 3D means the objects which we can hold by our hand, we can pick it up, we can place it to the other place. We are not just supposed to draw, or we cannot draw it on a flat surface. Okay, we need height also, we need width also, and we need length also to draw such an objects. So the objects with all three dimensions, we call it as three-dimensional objects. So now you can see the object on the screen. Just can you identify what it is? What object it is? If you know, you can.
Cube.
Otherwise, okay, very good, Prachi. It is a cube. We will see some more objects similarly. Okay, see, one more object is there. It also has a similar shape. The other one is a different object. The next one is a different object. It is a dice. But it has a similar shape. The third one is candle. Even the candle shape is also same, just like a dice. So if we know the name of the object, we call it as a cube. This we have learned earlier also. This is called a cube. Why it is called a cube? Because see, now you have to just observe. Okay, I will tell you. Okay, now see, the base, not only the base, the shape of the object is a square shape. If you will see one of the face of the object, you will identify, you will recognize that it is a square shape object. All the faces of this figure, of this object, are square and they are of same size. All the faces have equal length, all the length, height and width are similar, and the shape is a square shape. So the object which has six faces, and all the six faces are square and they have similar measurements, so such object is called a cube. Okay, just observe, there are difference between cube and cuboid. When you will see cuboid, you will able to recognize what is cube and what is cuboid. But now observe the cube. What is cube? So it is a square shaped object which has all six faces with similar measurements. Length, height, width, everything is similar. If the length is 6 cm, height will also be 6 cm, width will also be 6 cm. See here, this is a length. Okay, this is the length. This is 6 cm. And this is a height. This will also be 6 cm. And this will be the width. This will also be 6 cm. So this is three-dimensional figure. Length, height and width. Here also see, this is length, this is height, and width has gone at the back side. So this is the width. Okay, so it has three dimensions. We will call it three-dimensional figure, and the name of the figure is cube. Cube from net. Now what is net? Net means if I will open the cube and I will make it flat, that is called a net. Okay, if I have a box, if I will open the box and I will try to make it a flat, I will try to make it 2D shape, how it will look. Now see, this is a box. Oh, it is a cube. draw in your notebooks how will this box look when finally opened. So if I will open the box, that means I will try to make the box flat, how it will look. See, observe carefully, okay? Now this is the base of the box, okay? This is the base which is which I have put it on the ground. This is on the left side, this is the right side. This is to the north, this is to the south. That means all four walls of these are the four walls of a box, and this is the top portion. Here it is. This is the top portion. When I will make this right side of box, right side square stand, then this will come at the top of the box. So this is how the cube will look if I will try to open the cube. How many faces it, how many square it has, just count it.
Okay. Six squares.
Very good, Rudraksh. It has six squares. That means it has six faces. Okay, remember, it has six squares. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. You understood, na? When the box opens, how it looks. That means it has 6 squares in it. So, cube is made up of 6 squares. Let's go to the next. This is called a net. Okay, when you try to draw a 3D shape in 2D form, we can call it as a net. Just observe how from net how cube is made. Can you see when it is a net and when I will try to form a cube, how it will form? See, the similar earlier it is a net, and when I make it stand or when I try to make it as 3D, height, length and width, I will get a cube. Okay, so this is a cube. Now next we are going to see is one more shape. Now I have here, first I showed you the cube. Now I have a different shape. It is similar, not exactly similar to the cube, but this is also a 3D shape. See, observe the shapes. Okay, I have three figures, I have three objects here, and all the objects the shape of the objects is somewhat similar, but just the diamond, the measurements may be different, but the shapes are similar. See here, I have a length over here. This is my length. Okay. This is my height and this is my width. So tell me, can you tell me whether the length, height and breadth or all the three dimensions are similar or they are different? Just tell me whether it is similar, all the measurements are same or they have different measurements. Length is different, breadth is different, height is different, or they are same. By observing
cuboid.
Yes, it is called cuboid. But tell me whether the length and height and width are have similar measurement or they are different measure. They have different measurements.
Different measurement.
Very good. They have different. See, the length is slightly bigger. Slightly greater than the height, and then the width height is the smallest, height is smallest, okay, and then the width, and then the longest is the length. So see, in every shape we have similar only. Length is big and then width is slightly smaller and then the height. So they have different measurements, but it was not like this in the cube. In cube we have length, height and width, all same measurements. But this is not the case in cuboid. Cuboid have different measurements. So now you have you know the difference between cuboid and cube. So don't get confused what is cube and what is cuboid. Cube is a square shape object. Okay. And cuboid is a rectangular shape object. If you will observe the figure carefully, it is a rectangle. See, it is a rectangle, length and height and width. Okay, if you observe the figure, see, this is a rectangular shape. So when a shape when the 3D shape has a rectangular measurements, the shape look like a rectangle, we call it as a, the name of the shape is cuboid. Okay, this is a cuboid. So now cuboid from net, now see, this is a cuboid box. Any box, most, see, if you will observe the box which we get, mobile box, you know, it is also a rectangular shaped box. If you will observe the duster that we have in the school, it is also rectangular shape. If you will observe the cupboard that we have in our rooms, in our home, it is also a rectangular. If you have a cupboard, just observe the cupboard in your home, it is also a rectangular shape. Everything, like if you even with the mobile that we have, if it is slightly, if it has a slight height of 0.1 or 0.2 centimeter, it is also a cuboid. If you observe the radio that we have in the home, it is also a rectangular shaped cube. So that such shapes are called cuboids. Okay, it has a rectangular face. This is called a cuboid. So if I will try to open the cuboid, how it will look? It will look like this. So it has a all the six shapes are rectangular. See, this is a rectangular shape, rectangular, rectangular, and these are the small rectangles on the sides. So this is the base, this is the base at the ground, this is right side, left side, and the top one, and on the sides are the small, small rectangles. So this is how it will look if I will try to open the cuboid. You have observed, you might have done this, right? In schools, when we try to
make,
if in school we try to make some teaching aids, right? So teachers sometimes ask, bring a box. So we try to open the box. In school, we have done these things. Just you have to recollect it. So this is called a cuboid. When you open the cuboid, you will get like this figure. Okay. So now we have seen cube and we have seen cuboid. See, look how cuboid is formed. Just observe. If I will open the cuboid, how it will look. And then, if you will again join it, the box is formed. Okay. So now we'll go to the next. Now, see here. Can you make a cuboid using other cuboids? Give example. So yes, definitely we can make a cuboid from, if I will try to place similar shaped, similar measurements cuboid on one above the other, definitely I am going to get a big cuboid which is formed from a small cuboids. See here. Now this is a book. Okay, these are the books. A book have a length. Okay, this is the length. This is the width, and it also has a small height. Even though it is a small, but it has some height. So if you'll observe a book, see, our textbooks are very thin. So you will not be able to see the height. But if you will see the books of higher standards or of higher grades, you will be able to see they are thick books. They are very thick. So they also have a proper height. So see here, I have book. I have length also. It is not a cube shape. Okay. It is a cuboid shape. So I have length. I have height. I have width. If I will try to arrange these books on one above the other, see what I'm getting. So if I will see this figure, if I will try to join everything, I'm going to get a rectangular shaped box. If see, just you have to imagine these things, okay? I'm going to get a rectangular shaped box if I will try to put all these books, and if I will try to stick these books to one above the other. So I'm going to get a big rectangular shaped box. So this box, I can call it as cuboid. So yes, definitely we can make we can make cuboids using other cuboid. This was a small cuboid. but I tried to arrange it on one above the other, and then I got a big cuboid. This will not be the case in this will not be the case in the of cube, okay? Because cube should have similar measurements. All the 3D measurements are similar, so we cannot form a cube, okay? If I will place cube on one above the other, so what will happen? The length will increase or the height will increase, but the length and width will remain the same. So cube, we cannot form a cube. If I will place cube on one above the other, it will give me a cuboid only, okay? If I will put cube on one above the other, if I have a dice and I will try to put one dice on other and on other, so I will get a cuboid. I will not get a cube again, but if I will place cuboid one above the other, I am going to get cuboid only, okay? What next we are going to see, I have a bar magnets over here that we see in your science experiments, or that many of you have seen in our laboratories when we go for a visit. This is a bar magnets. It has North Pole and South Pole. If I will put this bar magnets on one above the other, okay? These are the bar magnets that we have to put one above the other. Observe what shape I have got. I have got a cuboid again. See, this will be my length. Okay. This small will be my width. And this will be my height. Even I'm trying to put it on the screen. I'm trying to write on the screen. You just observe. Okay. So this will be the height. So it has three dimensions. All the three dimensions have different measurements. So we can call it a cuboid. And yes, this is the second example which shows a bigger cuboid can be made by putting one cuboid on another. Okay. Next. Have a cuboid shape in your hand, that is geometry box, duster or eraser, anything. If you have in your hand, you can just take it in your hand, or if you don't have nearby, you just observe and identify what are the faces, edges and vertex. Now we are going to see what is faces, edges and vertex. These are the three concepts that we are going to see. Now we know what is cube and what is cuboid. Now we will see what is faces, edges and vertex. See, when we study about square, rectangle, triangle, we have studied what is sides, what is vertex, what is angles. And in last sessions also we have studied square has four sides, square has four angles, square has four vertexes. Then we have studied even of triangle also. Triangle has three sides, three vertices and three angles. So similarly, now we are going to study of cube and cuboid. So what cube and cuboid has, or the other 3D shape has, they have faces, edges and vertices. Okay, these are the things they have. So now what is the faces, what is edges and what is vertices? You will observe the figure carefully. See, I have one duster over here. If you have a cuboid shape box, you can take cuboid shape box in your hand and you can consider it as a duster and you can see. Now see, what is this? This is called a face. What is face? See, what is face when we talk about us? The face that we show to the people, our identity, one of the side of us, that is called a face. And the back side, we call it as a back. Okay, we call it front and back. That is, we have on the front side we have face, on the back side we have back. So we don't call it both side, we don't call face. But this is not the case in the case of cube and cuboid. See, this is called face, the flat surface that we have. This is called a face. This is one face. Here we have the other face, this one on the side, if you will see. Here we have the third face. At the down, we have the other face. Like this, if you will observe, on all the six sides we have different faces. So that is called face, matlab a flat surface. On the flat surface that we have all the six rectangles, different rectangles, we call it as a face. Okay, next is edge. Now what is edge? See, I told you the flat surface that is there, it is an edge, it is a face, and these borders are called edge. Okay, see here, so only I'm talking about borders. Observe, these are the borders. Okay, this is called an edge. This is the one edge, second edge, third edge, fourth one, here it is fifth one, and here it is sixth edge. This is the seventh, then it is eight, and at the back side also there are four more edges. That is 9, 10, 11, 12. So total there are 12 edges that we have to a cuboid. So what is now, see, what is face? Face matlab flat surface. Okay. What is edge? Edge matlab jo border hai, jo line hai, that is called an edge. And the third thing, that is vertex. Vertex means everybody know what is vertex. So vertex means the points, these points. The points where all the edges are meet each other, that point is called a vertex. So these points are called vertex. The lines, the borders are called edges, and the flat surface is called the face. Okay. See. Hold any cuboid in your hand and count the number of faces, edges, and vertices. This is a transparent cuboid that I have over here. You can see through it, and we can see how many faces, how many edges, and how many vertices it has. See, faces of cuboid are rectangle. So here I have a rectangular faces, that is the upper one, it is A, B, C, D. This is the upper rectangle. Okay. And then it is PQRS, that is the bottom, top and bottom rectangular I have over here. So these are the two faces, top face and the bottom face. Okay. Next is a square sided, that is on the sides, that is D, C, R, S, and on the other side, that is A, B, Q, P. Okay. It is getting a little bit messy, but try to understand. Okay. So these are the two different shapes again. So this two, the other two, and on the right and left, we have more, that is A, D, S, P, B, C, R, Q. See the other two. ADSP and BCRQ. These are the two more rectangles. So total faces that we have are six faces. Okay. The top, bottom, right, left, and to the both the sides. Okay. So this total six faces we have in the cuboid. Sometimes you also need to name them, because now we are going ahead, right, in geometry. So now you also have to name them. What are the faces? A B C D, then PQRS, DCRS, ABQP, then we also have ADSP, BCRQ. All this six rectangles you have to name it properly. Last lecture I have told you, you cannot jump from one point to other, you have to go in a sequence. So you need to go in a sequence. See, vertices that I have, that is A, B, C, D, P, Q, R, S, the points that I had. Okay, the edges that I have is A, B, B, C, C, D. See, what is edges now? see. What is edges? Edges means this lines, that is AB. This is one edge. BC, this is the other edge. CD, this is the other edge. And AD. These are the four edges. Next, PQ, one edge. QR, other one. RS, other edge. And PS, other edge. Okay, so the four at the top, four at the bottom. Eight edges. Then we have four on the side, that is DS. We have CR. Then we have BQ. And then we have AP. So total four at the top, four at the bottom, four at the sides. So the total edges that we have are four plus four, eight plus four, 12 edges. So we have to also name them, just not count. So A, B, B, C, C, D, A, D, these are the name of the edges. So there are total 12 edges and there are total four, eight vertices. And the faces also that we have seen, A, B, C, D, top, P, Q, R, S, bottom, A, B, P, Q, right, DCRS, left, then ADSP, then BCQR. These are the six faces that we have. Okay. See, the next one is cube. Similarly, same it is. Just you have to see. Now, here also we have six faces. As you know, cube, it has six faces. How is cube different from cuboid? First only, at the starting only, I have explained you why cube is different from cuboid. Can anyone tell me why cube is different from cuboid? Anyone, just in short. Just unmute yourself and try to answer.
Ma'am, yes. Cube have a square and cuboid have rectangle.
Very good, Avinash. Cube is a square-shaped box and cuboid is a rectangular-shaped box. So, this is a cube. If you will observe also, you will be able to see all the faces of the cube are same. That is, they have a same measurement. Length is equal to height is equal to width. See, I have mentioned over here. The length is equal to height is equal to width. That means they have same measurements. So the faces that we have over here is A, B, D, C, E, F, G, H, A, B, F, E, D, C, G, H. So this is the measurements that we have. So cube also has eight vertices. Cube also has 12 edges and the six faces, the names are given over here. Now see, this here we have is a triangular prism. Now what is triangular prism? So it has a triangular shapes. It has a triangular shape in it. So this shape is called a triangular prism. So it has two triangles and three rectangles in it. Count the number of vertices, edges, and faces from net. See, you can count in this net. It becomes very simple. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So it has how many faces? It has 5 faces. How many vertices it has? So it has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 7, 8, 9, and 10. So it has 6 faces. It has 10 vertices. Sorry, it has 5 faces, not 6 faces. It has 5 faces and it has 10 vertices. Now, how many edges it have? How many edges it has? If you have to count the lines, see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So how many edges it have? It has 14 edges. It has 5 faces, 10 vertices, and 14 edges. sorry, 5 faces, 9 edges and 6 vertices. Okay, so it has, okay. So because as you know, this will go this point and this point, they are going to meet each other. So it has 6 vertices, 9 edges and 5 faces. See the shape of prism, example of the shape of prism. Observe the different type of shapes in a triangular prism. So it has triangle and it has a rectangles. So it has 2 triangles and it has how many rectangles? It has 3 rectangles. Okay. Now cylinder. What is cylinder? Cylinder means a cylindrical shape object or a cylindrical shape. Now what is a cylindrical shape? Cylindrical shape means it has a circle at the top and the bottom and a curved face on the side. See here, I have a cylindrical objects and the top and the bottom, it is a circular face, and on the side it has a curved face. All these are cylindrical objects. Okay, when we talk about cylinder, so not, it is not that always we talk about a gas cylinder. Cylinder is a shape. Okay, we call that object as cylinder, but actually cylinder is a shape in mathematics. So this all objects are cylindrical shapes. Whenever you take a drink of a can, like this can type, or a standing standing tiffin, if I will take bottle, if I will take any, so that is called a cylinder, that have a cylindrical shape. But it should not be like of different shapes. The all this should be in a equal. See, it has a one edge, so it is not like it has like a curved shapes, not like this. It should be a straight. Okay, so we can call this shapes as cylindrical shapes. You will need a thick paper, scissor and a cello. See, if you want to make a cylindrical shape, cut a rectangular piece of paper and paste both the opposite sides. We always make it, na? If I have paper and in my hand, I try to roll it. When we go in a stationery shop for a cardboard or a card paper, what the shop person does, he just folds the paper. He just rolls. Sorry, not folding. He just rolls the paper and gives you. So that results in a cylindrical shape. Okay, see here. When I have a rectangular shape paper, any shape paper, if I'll try to roll that thing, I'm going to get a cylindrical shape. Okay. Now, to cover the ends of a cylinder, cut out 2 circles by drawing a circular outline of a cylinder on a paper. See, I want to cover it. I have made a roll, but what about the top and bottom? I cannot keep it open. I need to cover it. So now I need a circles. I need a similar shaped circles to cover it. See, so I have circles at the top and the bottom. I have circles of similar shape, and in the center I have a rectangular paper or a square paper which I have rolled, that is curved shape. Okay, that we can call it as curved face. What it has? It has a radius and it has a height, because circle is measured? Circle is measured with the help of radius only. And to measure the height, we need a height. See, this will be the net of our cylinder. If I will open the cylinder, like I have opened the cube and cuboid or a triangular prism, I will get this kind of shape. There are 2 circles and a rectangular shape. So it don't have any vertices. As you know, there is no point. What is vertex? So say when two segments join at a point. So there are no such things. So we can say there are no vertices. Edges, there are two circular edges, okay? And the top and the bottom. We have two circular edges. This is the edge, okay? This is the border that we have. So there are two circular edges, okay? And faces, how many faces it have? It have three faces, that is at the top one, at the bottom, and at the center, we have a curved face. So that there are two circular faces and one curved face, okay? Can you make a cylinder by using other cylinders? So yes, definitely. See, a big cylinder, cylindrical shaped, is formed with the help of a small cylinders. Okay. So now, okay. So now we have. So today we have what all things we have seen. So we have seen. So see, we have seen a rectangular prism. We have seen what is vertices. We have seen what is an edges. We know what is faces. What is triangular prism? We also now this five things we have seen. We have also seen cylinders. Okay. We know what is net. I told you what is net. So net is a thing when I try to put a 3D object in the form of 2D object. If I will open that object, I'm going to get a net of that object. So these are the things that we have seen today. So I will try to the next things that is quadrilateral pyramid, triangular pyramid, cone, sphere, apex, that we'll be seeing in the next session. Okay. So today we have seen all these things. So thank you, students, for attending the session.